Without God, everything might not be possible. But with Him, nothing shall be impossible. I believe everyone in here, including myself, have strength. Without Him, I might not get a chance to finish my speech or graduate from grade school or even high school. My main Bible verse is Luke 1:37. For with God, nothing shall be impossible. I chose this Bible verse because it's related to my life experience. You guys might not know, when I was a freshman, I was completely a different person. Probably like a no better. And okay, I don't talk to people that often because I was quite shy. And the first Thanksgiving came out, and I have no friends, so I was struggling. And Thomas came to me, was like, "Would you like to stay at my house?" I'm like, "Sure, why not, since I don't have an option." And after break, we start hanging out and start playing football, and I get to know a lot of friends. And I believe God put those people in my life, which is a gift. And Luke also wrote the two words, the third gospel, the account of life, the book of arts, which is about the explanation of Christianity. He also recorded the lifetime of Jesus from about 3 BC to 60 AD. And I also found this following verses, which is also related to strength. The first one is Matthew 19:26. But Jesus looked at them and said, "With man this is impossible, but with God everything are possible." The second one is Jeremiah 32:27. "Behold, I'm the Lord, the God of all flesh. Is anything too hard for me?" The last one, Mark 10:27. Jesus looked at them and said, "With man it is impossible, but not with God. For all things are possible with God." Those are just some course reference about my, which is related to strength. And I'm going to show you a real life story, how this man showed his strength. And you may use it. You may look at your handout right now. This young man, he has dwarfism, which makes him the size of 3 years old. Make him the size of a 3 year old. Oh, I'm sorry. So this is a picture of him, and you can see how short he is. His younger brother mentioned, even though he's shorter than he is, but he's older than Nick is older than he is, he still look up to him. And what's the first word come up from your mind when you think of a basketball player? Tall, right? Okay. This is my buddy LeBron James, right? What's up, buddy? I mean, look at how tall he is and how muscular he is. I'll probably not play basketball with him. I probably can't take a hit. That's how I stopped playing basketball. But this young man, even though he's short, he still didn't give up his dream. I've looked at videos how he dribbled the ball and do those layup. I'm like, man, I don't want to play basketball with this guy. I'm worrying about my ankles. And on your handout, there's a news about how he showed his strength to the football player. He was doing push-ups in front of the Georgia college football players. He showed his strength physically by doing push-ups, and showed his self-confidence by stepping out in front of the football players, and he also showed his own worth. And it is applied to believers and unbelievers. For believers, you can learn how confident he is within ourselves. As the Bible said, we are all fearfully and wonderfully made. For unbelievers, we can take this as example of what this man said and what he have done by having confidence and know who we are. If we have God as our main source of strength, we will be able to accomplish everything we propose to. The message of Luke 1:37 can be applied to everyone. It can be believers or unbelievers. If God is with us, nothing will be impossible. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Let's give a round of applause. Thank you, Richard.